I swear the show. I cannot. I'm sweating.
Before we start this video, I just would like to thank all my patrons that are going above and beyond to support my channel. You guys are amazeballs. I would also like to thank my subscribers and to those who supported me since the beginning, especially the Weight Army peeps. Thank you guys, you are all amazing.
What is up guys, Athena here, and welcome back again to another Full Metal Alchemist reaction episode. So before we start this next one, I just want to congratulate Riza from finding a way to share the development about Selim to Mustang. That was pretty clever. The Morse code moment was so exciting to watch. I was like at the edge of my seat while they were doing it. Although that episode was jam-packed with exciting stuff, that was probably one of the best scenes from the episode for me. I know it was a lot, you know, with Hohenheim and everything. And I also think it was pretty clever for all of the writers to insert the flashbacks in the middle of the season. And for one big reason. Now, we now know exactly what a nationwide transmutation circle looks like and what it does. It was disgusting. You know, it was quite an unforgettable scene where, you know, the image of Hohenheim discovering all of his dead friends and then looking out upon the city and seeing it littered with dead bodies, kids, grandmas, women, his friends, like a whole nation. What? That was so Filipino. A whole nation wiped out in one day. That is crazy. Just to make a huge philosopher's stone, a walking philosopher's stone. And this is what is going to happen to Amestris if they don't do anything with whatever, if they don't stop Father's plan, you know? A lot of things were revealed previous episode, but the icing on the cake was knowing that Ed and Al came from a human philosopher's stone. That's just like, that's crazy. And I said it in the outro of a previous episode, that is probably the reason why they have this weird relationship with this god truth thing, like, you know, that door or whatever they have. I don't know, it's just like this weird connection that they have, because they get to like talk to him or it or the god. And it's just so casual for them to be going in and out of the door. Like, you know, but for people, it's like, if you go in, you can't go out because you're dead. You know, it's like, that's the afterlife, not the afterlife. You're dead because it's so, you know, like, same with Izumi, because, you know, she did the same thing as what Ed and Al did. But the only difference is they came from Hohenheim. They have his genes and everything, so I don't know what to come up with. It's like, I don't know, how do we go from here? I have no idea, but I guess we'll find out today. Pretty sure there's gonna be more revelation to come, because we are at episode 41, and you know, if the writers was like, okay, here, I'm giving you all these informations, take it all in, Otane. So anyway, I'm excited today, so let's go.
So before we start this video, please support my channel by giving this video a like. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell button to get the latest videos.
Day. Oh, here we are. Wait, these is, yeah, Ed and Al's group. Sure, Al. I say Ed and Al's group, but I know that they're not with them. I just say it. Because they were together previously. Oh, they can't be used. Well, you can dry them up with alchemy, I think. Can you? I don't know. Myruzu.
Central から来た部下たち、計3名、隙を見て仕留める。
The Abyss. Hold on. Another Abyss. I just watched Made in Abyss earlier. And we're getting another Abyss. This... Yeah, the things that I watched recently is, like, quite stressful. But fun. I really enjoy them. I would have stopped if I didn't enjoy them, you know? I can't blame these guys. Like, they've been living in a harsh place, and you know, it's cutthroat, so it is what it is. Everyone was like that at the beginning, but then you get to learn life, meet lots of people. Yeah, for sure. Yeah, like he's still, you know, instilling his views, his... Yeah, nothing changed about Ed and Al, even with, like, the people that they've met. It's crazy. But I suppose that's the hero for you. The hero of the show. What? Immortality in gold. Eastern Alchemy. I'm confused as well. Ah. Their dad? Okay! That changes everything. I mean, that makes sense. So if he, if he showed them, the Eastern Alchemy, then what is the alchemy in Amestris? So there's a good and bad alchemy? Because, like, clearly the ones that they use is, like, for healing and, like, you know, the good stuff. Because it was Hohenheim that taught them, but... Oh, that's an owl! How did he get in that situation? Avalanche? Oh. May. You slimy girl. It's faster.
Mm.
I know the way. Aspect. I guess you need to change your uniforms. Well, actually, they're handcuffed, so. Oh, he made a fake armor. Wait, so who's moving the armor then? Is he doing that like puppeteer thing with the armor? Oh. The way he walks, no, and the way he talks. It's so funny. Kimberly is gonna know. He's gonna know. How will he know? He will know. Like I said. Oh. Kagebunshin no jutsu. What is he doing? Let them shoot the guy. He is doing this Emma thing as well, you know, talk no jutsu. He wants to talk to the demon. You could have denied it, you know. There's that denial thing that you call denial. You deny things. Just do it. I'm sure he's gonna do something to, don't do it. Explosion! Of course. Smoke screen. Oh! What? Ow. I'm pretty sure these are chimeras as well. Look at this. He is a gorilla and he's a tiger. A lion. Yep. Of course. Ah! I don't know, he's a bad guy. I know he's a bad guy. I shouldn't. No. I'll try my best. But he's just so they can smell you though. They're not supposed to kill him, right? Because father still needs him. Was that their plan? It just made me shorter. They're wet though. Look at this, like I said, there is a way for you to dry them up. fart. Oh my gosh. Oh, that was funny. I know, like, you use ammonia to, like, wake up an unconscious person. And I'm not sure if ammonia is also, like, an element in farts. I have no clue. I'm, like, not... I'm the wrong Asian here. Look. Don't ask me with anything about science or maths. Is it gonna eat it? Thank God for Winry. Oh, it fell. Ow. Oh! His transmutation circle is broken. Well, he has another one on his other hand, right? He has another Philosopher's Stone. Imagine. Oh my gosh. Why am I so sharp and not sharp at the same time with things? Oh. This is horrible. So I'm pretty sure those two chimeras are dead. They're like buried, but Kimberly and Ed for sure survived. Yeah, because they're the main cast. Oh, they're still alive. I mean, they're still alive because obviously they're chimeras. Oh, he's bleeding. Oh. Oh my God. You're in near-death situation again, Ed. What the fuck? What do we do? Winry's not here. You need a doctor. Oh my gosh. Oh no, you're dead again. Oh, they're gonna go back to that door. Oh my gosh. You're gonna go to the door. Yes, 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 yes. Because something happened to Ed. Ouch. Come on, Ed. It's just your kidney or your liver. It's nothing. He still has time to think about other people. Well, at least he is getting two more allies. You better help him. They're gonna help him. I'm touched. Pull it. Oh, it's gonna be painful. Makes sense. I can't watch. I want to take this off so bad. Jiggly. I swear this show. I cannot. I'm sweating. It's too much. Too much. Whew. Wow. That's my boy. I mean, it makes sense that he's good at, you know, this, because he is half his dad. What? That doesn't make sense. He is half a philosopher's stone. There is a thing called resting before a fight, Al. I love that he's getting allies, like, you know. In his way to, like, or this journey. Oh! Hmm. I thought he was gonna eat it. I wonder what's going to happen if Ed ingests a Philosopher's Stone. Wow, I can finally breathe. This show has just, like, they show you these scenes, like, out of the blue, like, without any warning, you know? It's like, hey, fun scenes here and there, first few scenes in the episode, and then eventually you get this pulling out a thing out of someone's gut. Like, ah! Okay, that casual reveal that it was Hohenheim who created the alchemy of the East. Like, it was so casual. They were like, yeah, it was that golden white man who showed us the way. It was great. And then he walked off. So it was so casual. Like, I would have thought that it would be like the people in that area, you know, that came up with the alchemy of healing and all that stuff. But it was Hohenheim. But, you know, it's not a surprise. He is a walking philosopher's stone and he knows a lot of things. He had been here in this world for how many years? And yeah, and also Ed kind of showed us that he can do it as well when he was trying to like fix himself. Yeah, there's no question to that because he came from Hohenheim. And you know, like, it's great. This episode is just wonderful. Like, it's mainly about Ed, though. Ed's growth. And it's at this point that this episode sets up one of the most important scenes of the series. Because it kind of shows us and makes us understand Ed's growth and characterization. I mean, this show does examination of identity and morality so fucking good. Like, despite everything that happened to Ed, he doesn't waver in his belief that he should not kill anyone. And Ed's anger, in my opinion, is both a flaw and a weapon. Like, in the context of what he does in this episode, like, his anger is a motivating gift, you know? Not only that, but he refuses to let the same Chimeras who tried to kill him die as well. Like, he deliberately values their life, even if it's just so that they can help him. But there is, in my opinion, there is also a little bit of luck. A little bit of luck on his side as well, because some enemies are not that forgiving and understanding. And it's just, you know, he's just lucky because those Chimeras were quite understanding with his situation. And if it was Kimblee who he would have saved, he wouldn't survive. I'm pretty sure Kimblee would have killed him, like, even if he saved Kimblee. Like, it doesn't, you know, it makes more sense. But I suppose he made two allies in the process. And yeah, this episode is beautiful. It's just so beautiful. I get to like learn more about Ed and Al. I know Ed survived. Al is unconscious and I'm pretty sure he's back to that place again. He's being called because of the situation Ed was in earlier. So I don't know what's going to happen to my boy. So I guess we'll find out next episode. So, and that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this reaction episode, and thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Janet!